What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. I can't even believe it. This is the 400th episode of My Corvette Life. Seems like just yesterday I started this YouTube channel, and now we're almost to 20,000 subscribers. We've got a couple thousand more to go, and we'll be there. But 400 videos. If you're new to the channel, I've got a bunch of playlists. Go check them all out. I got C5, C4, some truck content, and some other stuff as well. So plenty of content. So today I've got a little bit of an interesting topic, and that is rolled curbs. So rolled curbs are really popular here in the Phoenix area. They probably are in other places as well. So this is what's called a rolled curb. It's kind of like a valley gutter in front of a sidewalk. So it's pretty common in front of driveways, but it makes it a little difficult when you have a really low sports car to, clear this without scraping. Basically, you have to take the approach at a wide angle in order to get up over the curb without scraping the front end. My C5 is lowered to the extent that even if I do take a pretty wide approach, it still scrapes. And if I don't take a wide enough approach, that happens. So yeah, I cracked my $400 C7 carbon front splitter. So in order for me to not accidentally ever do that again, I went ahead and bought a product that should help mitigate that. So there are a few ramps out on the market. There's one that is called the Bridget, and it's basically a solid piece of rubber that you lay in that gutter. Fantastic product, but really expensive. It's like $400 for a 12-foot section. As an alternative, Camping World sells one that's basically just a really thick plastic ramp with a 2x4 underneath it. So here's the one I got. It's actually on sale right now for $175. Normally it's almost $200. This is the Bridget. You can see the pictures right there. It's basically just a solid piece of rubber. Fantastic product. I have no issues with it whatsoever. It's just really expensive, $400. This, on the other hand, seems to do the job. That's kind of an exploded view. And I've got it right over there in the box. So let's go ahead and take it out of the box and take a look. So here we go, box open. Here's the directions. Looks relatively easy, just a matter of putting it together. So let's go ahead and do it. So basically what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to set this up in the curb in our driveway so it's somewhat molded to fit our specific curb. So like you see here, this is exactly how it's going to go. So let's go ahead and get it laid out in our curb and screw it all together. So this is more or less what the finished product's gonna look like. Sorry for the wind noise, but not too bad. And these big plastic pieces, or excuse me, these big black pieces are actually rubber. I originally thought they were plastic because the photos kind of looked like plastic, but they're thick rubber. So that's good. That means the sun won't totally destroy them. Now, depending on your particular valley cover, that wood board could move one way or another. That's why they put so many spots to put screws in there, so it's adjustable for different applications. So, ramp seems like it works pretty well. I'm gonna try it out, see how it lasts and what its durability is and everything. I'll let you guys know sometime in the future. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please smash the thumbs up button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. And I will put a link to that ramp in the description below, so go check it out. See you guys later. Take care.